Don't pull me up so I can't help it. When the shadows are too heavy, and I know you know it's wrong, but I'm ready. So just rid yourself of him and forget it. Got you in touch from the middle. You know I'm willing to be able, and I know you know it's only ready. So just free yourself of him and come in.
Another episode of Thy Live B2B Jam Session. Happy Mellow Wednesday, where you're tuning in from. We are joining you from Oakland, California. The West Coast is in the building, Town Biz. I know we usually have a lot of Oaklandites who are tuned into the show. If you are hailing in from Oakland today, show some love in the comments. We will give you a shout out. We always love giving shout outs on the show because we always love knowing where people are joining us from so we can recognize them and acknowledge them. So show us some love in the comments and, you know, get engaged because we're going to have a really great episode today. We're talking to a wonderful leader and that I'm really excited about. And this is his first time on the show, but you may have heard of him. And, you know, I always ask people, let me know if you've heard of who we're talking to today, because if you've heard of him, then it's like, what? Like, we need to have him back on the show more often because he's blowing up. I think, you know, he's been doing this thing for quite some time. I'm really excited because he talks about a topic that I'm really, really passionate about, which is remote leadership and just leadership in this new era of work. You know, Jonathan Hensley is the CEO of Emerge. Don't you just love that name? Emerge, a digital product agency where he works with clients to transform business strategies, user needs, and new technologies into valuable products and services. He's an accomplished writer and speaker. He's lectured on topics such as the connected consumer's impact on business, creating value through data-driven experiences, and user-centric approaches to innovation. Love that stuff because customer-driven innovation is actually one of my biggest passion areas. And in 2012, he was actually recognized in the Portland Business Journal's 40 Under 40. 40 Under 40, y'all. Probably a little bit better than Forbes 30 Under 30. I think Forbes 30 Under 30 is way overhyped. Portland's Business Journal 40 Under 40 is definitely much better, more local, as one of Portland's emerging professional and community leaders. Man, shout out to Jonathan. And he's been building Emerge for quite some time. And they're committed to a simple philosophy for those who are tuning in, which is the relationship between Emerge and its clients should exist to create real and lasting and enduring value. And I'm going to be sharing links to his LinkedIn and Twitter, as well as his website, so you can give him a follow and learn a little bit more about the movement he's leading with Emerge. But, you know, we're going to be diving deep on a lot of different topics that Jonathan has his hands in, from, you know, his experience writing a book on organizational alignment when it comes to being a leader in this new era, as well as, you know, our shared passion for education and skilling and skills training and upskilling your people. With that said, Jonathan, welcome to the show, my friend.
Thanks, Tim. It's great to be here.
Dude, it's an honor to have you on the show, man. How are you doing, man? Where are you joining us from today?
I'm in, luckily today it's beautiful and sunny here in Portland, Oregon, so which is a rarity. Usually it's raining and cold, so it's a great day.
Dude, you know, I've never been to Portland, man. It's on my list. It's on my to-do list someday, man, because I've heard so many amazing things about the vibes there.
It's an awesome place. I mean, great creative community, you know, bustling and growing tech sector up here. I mean, yeah. It's a fun place to visit. So you got to come up here and let me know when you do.
Dude, I definitely will. But it sounds like my type of city, to be honest with you. Dude, Jonathan, I would love for you to share, because so you live in Portland now. You've been in Portland for quite some time, building Emerge. Did you start building Emerge in Portland, or was that somewhere else?
Actually, I started building the company when all the way back in the late 90s. And I was going between Eugene, where I went to college at the U of O, University of Oregon, for people that aren't familiar with the acronym. And also, I had a lot of family, and I grew up when I was young in the Bay Area. So I was going back and forth. And, you know, it was just became a passion play for me in the beginning, and then evolved into a career and eventually a thriving business.
Wow, that's amazing, man. So I want to show love to our amazing community guide members and listeners. Alberta Allen, she was a master's education, I believe. Hello from Atlanta. Hey, Hotlanta. Shout out to Hotlanta, man. I love Atlanta. We also have a member of ours who is a part of our Facebook community tuning in from Phoenix, Arizona. Shout out to Phoenix. As well as, I cannot even pronounce this name, but it seems like it looks like a beautiful name. It definitely looks like it's from Greece. Hello from Central Greece. I wish I could pronounce your name. Please share the English version of your name with me so we can do it justice. Thank you so much for tuning in from Greece. I love it when we have international listeners on the call, because it just lets us know the magnitude of how many people we reach with our show. So Jonathan, you started Emerge, you know, years ago. In this space of really helping, you know, leaders figure their stuff out, you know, because there's a lot of bad leaders. And I've worked with some, we've seen some, you know, for you, you know, in your career journey, man, I would love for you to share a little bit more about, you know, how do you define leadership in this new era? You know, it's 2021 now. And, you know, if anything, last year, COVID-19 taught us, like, man, like, businesses have to adapt their leadership model. So how do you define leadership in the era of now?
That's a great question. I think that, you know, in years past, their leadership was kind of this assumed thing by title, and leadership has nothing to do with title. That's just your position in an organization. Leadership is about inspiring people to follow you. And I think leaders today understand that servant leadership is what it's about, that we are there to not solve the problem, but we are there to create an environment to empower others to unleash their potential and solve the problems that we need to solve, whether it's for our customers or internally, and really make sure that we're focused on unlocking that potential. We have to create that environment. It has to be safe. It has to be innovative. It has to be creative. And servant leadership is about creating that environment. And I think that is absolutely the core of the best organizations and the best product service delivery teams out there in the world today.
100%. I live by that philosophy. You know, a fun fact about me, for some of our listeners who are tuning in, man. So Jonathan, actually, my dad, he's a pastor back home in Texas. And, you know, he literally lives that servant leadership philosophy. He's been a pastor for quite some time now, and really like leading with community first. And I think I've noticed there is this trend, and the most successful companies of today's generation, they are leading with community, and they're very servant, they're very relationship focused. And I think a great case study would probably be like Airbnb, who really pivoted their business model during the pandemic to optimizing around their hosts. So I completely agree with you, man.
It's such an important thing to understand that, you know, leaders today, what got them to where they are is not the skill sets that they're going to need to get their organization the next level tomorrow. And that servant mentality helps them step outside of ego, helps them start to address, you know, bias from their own life experiences and expertise, and really tap into the incredible potential of the people that they're collaborating with. And that mentality really drives the longevity and relevance of leadership within an organization.
Mm-hmm. Dude, so I it's so powerful, man. Like you're literally speaking to the choir, man. I'm just like listening. Like I could write a book right now. You know, so I would like to dive deep on your most recent book, Jonathan, because I think it's something that you said you've been working on for quite some time. You know, talk to us a little bit about the most recent book that you announced, and you know, what are some of the things that people who are listening can find when it comes to framing how they should lead high impact organizations?
Yeah, so the most recent book is called Alignment and Overcoming Internal Sabotage and Product Failure. And the focus of the book really evolved over the last 2 years. It started off as more of how to help leaders and teams connect and build a bridge, but it became something so much more as I was interviewing executives and engineers and UX designers and people all over the organization. And it became something so much bigger than I ever anticipated. And we just started to see these themes emerge from the entire process that were just inspiring to us. And so the book became something of its own, and really understanding, you know, that there's a conversation that people, I think, and at a fundamental level understand alignment, but it needs to be dissected and looked at from a leadership lens of what it means in the space of technology and being customer centric and innovative. And so the book really tackles that. It tries to provide, you know, people with, no matter if they're sitting in the C-suite or they're, you know, coming in, you know, straight out of college and it's their first, you know, product job within an organization, you know, some of the fundamentals that will help them thrive as they go forward. And so this is really curated insight from my own 20 plus years of experience and working with organizations as much as the incredible individuals who participated in the project. And so the foundation of the entire book really started around this idea of that alignment is this one core thing. It's the heart of every successful relationship, team. It's at the heart of our organizations and our fit within the market. And so to understand that a little bit more, what we really did is started to peel back the layers of understanding, you know, how does an organization need to think about alignment? How do leaders need to embrace that? And what does that mean to develop it? And so we focused on individual alignment, which is understanding how your work matters, finding purpose, and how you make a difference. We focused on team alignment, dealing with how people bring together and integrate the unique disciplines, experiences, and perspectives, and can co-create to solve incredible problems or unlock new opportunities. And then organizational alignment, dealing with how an organization aligns all of their resources, their people, their processes, and their systems to achieve a larger vision. And then aligning with the market, understanding what customers really need and want, and how we solve problems in effective ways.
Man, that's powerful. So alignment from a lot of different perspectives, which is, you know, often people think alignment is just like, I got to align my team. We got to align the org. We got to do all hands. But then I think I love the fact that you're bringing this outside the dimension of, well, what about customer alignment? Market, because like market fit, product market fit, or business customer fit, like, are you aligned to where the customer journey is going? You know, I want to dive deep here, John, because I think it's so fascinating for some of the people who may not be listening that are middle managers or even executive roles. For you, talk to us a little bit about the process of writing the book. Was there an organization or someone that really gave you gems or, you know, struck a chord with you during the writing process?
Well, there were so many. I mean, what I started off doing was really, I let the experts from the outside shape the narrative. I took my own medicine. You know, when we do product development, we preach the customer, you know, it's all about the customer. It's about being customer centric, which means starting with empathy and focus on finding the truth in the subject. Mm. And we took the exact same approach to writing the book. You know, and I worked through that process through how I conducted interviews, the research that was done around the book, and really making sure that we took a holistic picture of this topic by bringing in people at every level of the organization and people that had successfully built and led organizations for decades in this. And so that was really important. And we really wanted to tap into, you know, some of these key insights that they had of leading teams that might have been small from 2 to 3 people all the way up to building teams of thousands of people that they're responsible for. And so it was really important. And the lessons are equally applicable to any scale of business.
Yeah, I love books like that. It sounds like you really covered a range of different types of case studies, I love that you're not giving too much away, because we want the listeners, we want our audience to definitely go out and buy the book and learn a little bit more about this topic area, because I think, you know, in the context of the times that we're living now, you know, leaders need to be dynamic. And, you know, one of the things that's really exciting to me about, you know, what you're doing, and I think for me, I have to read the book, is that, you know, how are you aligning your organization when everyone is spread out? It's truly a problem that a lot of leaders, some of them don't have the energy for it. Even some the people who are doing the work, they don't even have the energy for it, because they're like, I need help with managing my schedule and managing my home life and taking care of my kids. So I think it's gonna hit home for a lot of people who are listening right now.
It's, you know, it's such an interesting thing that comes up too, is like, one of the questions through the process that kept coming up is, well, who's responsible for alignment? And I think this is a really interesting thing, because, you know, we talk about our shared passion for education and for, you know, self-development before, and, you know, the responsibility, it is a responsibility of leaders of organizations to be the stewards and the caretakers of alignment. That is their mission in the organization. Their purpose is there to build that alignment so they can successfully serve the customer. Now, I also would argue, though, that it's equally a responsibility that's not in a single job description for every single person within an organization to ask for that clarity. And I think that is part of, you know, customer experience being served by great employees who have a great employee experience and can understand how they're making a contribution. And so one of the things we learned is that a lot of the leaders that we talk to are more playing a role of coaching their teams and asking them, you should ask me these questions. You should talk about these kinds of things. You should dig into this, you know, let your curiosity be unleashed. And that we found that to be really fascinating. And that took us down in this incredible path where we met a neuroscientist by the name of Dan Cable, who wrote an incredible book called Alive at Work. And, you know, he really talked about in, you know, our discussions and in his book about how alignment is actually not something that's just smart business or a psychological need, but we actually, there is a biological component to the necessity of alignment as human beings. And so it is an incredible source of a strategic advantage for organizations and leaders to tap into this need that we have. We have this insatiable curiosity that we need to make sure is fulfilled. And, you know, and the most basic definition of it is cause and effect. If I do this, what happens?
Yeah.
We need to fulfill those needs so that we really do have teams focused and putting their energy into the most important things. Otherwise, we fill the gaps based on our life experiences and perceptions. And that usually may not be actually aligned. It may be misaligned with the intention of the organization.
Man, this is going to be, I think, dude, this should be a New York Times bestseller, should enough, man, because no, it's so relevant. Even for me as a leader, it's so relevant to what I have to kind of go through when it comes to leading our teams and just saying, this is our focus, this is what we should be doing. But also applying that to my life is like, where am I exerting enough energy towards where we need to go as an organization, and how am I spending my time? And I think, you know, one of the things that I love about the book is kind of, I think, about what you're speaking, because it's like, you have to be reflective, right, of how you're aligning yourself. It's not like you just align yourself, but you have to be like, okay, am I headed in the right direction in terms of this set alignment with my individual self, but also with our team? Because we might have to course correct here and there as the market changes.
Yeah, it's really been fun to look at different facets of it as well and how it unfolds. And, you know, what are techniques that you can use to build alignment? I think, you know, one thing that we realized very quickly is, and we've always done for ourselves, is been students of failure. Instead of falling in love with solutions and the things that we're creating, we really make sure that we understand the problem and never lose sight of that problem in our work. But as we went through and started talking to people about the importance of building organizations and leadership, one of the key things with that was really understanding how do we, you know, step out of issues like our confirmation bias. And I'll give you an example, because we all do this, is that we have an idea and then we start to seek out information to help us validate that idea. And that's why having, you know, perspective and teams that bring their unique point of view to the picture is so critical. And I think we see that, you know, outside of business, we see that, you know, in communities, and we see that in government. It's all over the place. We need more perspective. We need more empathy. We need more focus on the right things. And so being able to translate that, you know, people can really make this personal for themselves and bring that then to their work and into their organizations if they understand these principles.
And I think it really touches on the larger, broader conversation that we're having around diversity, equity, and inclusion. And the reason why inclusive, diverse teams from the ground up, or even if you have to, you know, decree top-down mandates within your organization of hiring and really thinking about rethinking how you're building in that diverse pipeline, I think it speaks to why it's so important. Because when you lose that perspective advantage within your organization, it affects alignment in a lot of ways, because you don't get a kind of full context on who your customer is. Because, you know, if you have such a homogenous culture of, you know, certain type of people, you're only going to be really positioned and aligned to support that kind of person in the broader market. Jonathan, man, I feel as if we can talk for days, but now I know you have places to be and things to do. Jonathan, could you please share with our amazing community, you know, where they can follow you in your amazing journey and what you're doing with Emergent? You know, are you doing a free book giveaway? You know, any discounts? What? How can we be a part of Jonathan's Emerge club and get a hold of the book?
Absolutely. So if you want to get some resources and free things, please visit emergeinteractive.com. We have a whole great insight section with tons of resources there for supporting building alignment and product leadership. And I would encourage anybody to check that out if they're looking for some good, you know, tidbits there. The other thing is I spend most of my time in LinkedIn, like a lot of people these days. So, you know, please reach out to connect with me, follow me there. I'm putting out content all the time. There'll be a bunch of information coming out for the new book release just in the next week or so. And the book will be coming out later this month. We'll have a big promotion coming out with the launch. So, you know, get in touch with me. I'll make sure you get that discount and get access to the book hot off the press.
Love it, man. Yeah, dude, please give us access, man. You know, if I can get a copy, bro, I would love it. I'll buy one nonetheless.
I'll send one to you right a day of.
Thank you, Jonathan. Appreciate you, man. Looking forward to talking to you soon, man.
Yeah, thank you, Tim.
That was the wonderful Jonathan Hensley, who literally, you know, just blessed us with a lot of wisdom, put us on a lot of game, a lot of gems. I love everything that he's working on, from really thinking about organization alignment with their teams to what does digital or hybrid leadership look like in today's generation. So please check him out. Throughout the show, I have shared his links to his LinkedIn, his website, and Emerge's site on what they're doing and how they are a digital product agency, really focused on ensuring that you're delivering amazing products based on transformational technology for your customers. So check out Emerge, super, 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 super awesome company and led by an awesome, amazing leader in Jonathan Hensley, who's an author, speaker, and co-founder and the CEO at Emerge. So make sure you check them out and check out his movement. Lead his movement with him if you're a fan. With that said, thank y'all so much for tuning in. Want to share with our amazing community, for those of you who have bought some tea and you're like, dude, Tim, my tea has not gotten here yet. Guys, we're so sorry. Some crazy stuff has been happening with COVID-19, literally, and it has caused our logistics to be bottlenecked, and we are waiting for the tea to get here and be in our inventory. and it's due to a FedEx delay. So we apologize if you've not gotten your tea yet, but you can continue ordering the tea. We do have inventory coming that will not prevent you from ordering online, but we apologize for those of you who have been waiting, some of you for months and weeks now on the tea. You know, COVID times, you have to adapt, and we are adapting, we are learning, and we are definitely growing with you, our amazing community. Also, if you are a creator and you are passionate about creating content around professional development and growing in your career, right, and you share professional relevant educational content, right, content that helps people grow in their career, in their lives, and in the world, in the new world of work, please, 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 please sign up for our Guide Beta. You can sign up on guidegroup.com, sign up for Guide Beta. We are gradually expanding our beta. We have a lot of awesome things in store for the next few months, and especially this month. So, you know, keep leading your movement with us. As always, once again, this is not a shameless plug, but a shameless open welcome. If you think you are doing something that we have to highlight, please reach out to me directly at utfow.com. utfow.com. We are always taking guests for the Guide Live B2B Jam Session show, and we always recognize our guests and recognize all the amazing things that they are doing. So please, you know, join us and lead your movement with us. As always, our platform is your platform. All right, y'all. Talk to you all soon. Peace, love, and gonna cap you all off with a nice, cool, slow jam by the bars.